Children, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 4, Fight Manju Fight by Sigrun Srivastava. So before reading the chapter, we will do some pre-reading task. Imagine a situation wherein you are suffering from a very high fever and you are to appear for a very important examination the next day. What will you and your friends do? Discuss in groups of 5. Do hurdles dishearten you? Are you afraid of hurdles? Or give you greater strength? Or you feel, you know, excited or you feel empowered from your hurdles? Share your opinions with your friends. Whatever you think, you can share it with your family members. Friends are not available, I think. So, before beginning with the chapter, I will tell you what is the chapter all about. In this chapter, there is a girl, Manju. The full name is Manjula. So, you know, she was suffering from some kind of malformation. So, her life was a great struggle. But then also, she felt motivated. How is that possible? We will see that. Now, read the story of a young girl, Manju, who does not let adversities hamper her ambitious spirit. Adversities means unfavorable things hamper to stop her ambitious spirit. Manjula Parelkar knew she was no Hussein. Hussein here, M.F. Hussein, a great painter. She knew that she wasn't Hussein. She could never be, not with those hands of hers. You can see her fingers are deformed. Her fingers are not like us. But she was a good painter. But she was thinking with these kind of hands, she will not be able to become a good painter. Those claw-like malformed finger. Claw, you must have seen the claws of birds. She was referring her fingers to claws. Malformed, they were badly formed. They were not in a proper manner. Why her hands too? Wasn't it enough that her feet were deformed, ending in two massive moon-shaped toes pointing at each other? So not only her hands, her feet were also like that. She was thinking that why my hands also? Wasn't my feet enough to be deformed? So she was, you know, in a great pain. The hard nails touching, grating each other whenever she wore wrong shoes. She wore wrong shoes most of the time, for there weren't any shoes in the market soft enough for her clumsy feet. You know, regular shoes were not made for her, but she was not able to find proper shoes for her awkward, large and heavy feet. So they always hurt. Her feet hurt most of the time, but she didn't mind them so much. You know, most of the time she felt pain in her feet, but she never minded that. So she could hide them in those ugly made-to-order shoes, but she could not hide her hands, could she? Now, you know, special ordered shoes were made for her, so her feet would hide in them, but her hands are bare. We cannot hide our hands every time. Manjula Parelkar knew she would never paint like Hussein, but she could learn to paint well. Handling brushes was no problem. They didn't feel any different from a pencil. Her problem was the cost of the materials she would need. So, you know, Manjula, she wanted to become a good painter. She knew that she will never be equal to M.F. Hussein. But she wanted to learn good painting. And she was able to color also. She was able to handle the brushes also. But what was the problem? The problem was the cost of the materials. You know, all the materials that are required in painting, the cost of those materials was a big problem for her. Mummy, she asked one evening, while helping her mother in the kitchen after dinner, do you think I could? She paused nervously. I could have some extra money tomorrow. One day after dinner, when she was helping her mother in the kitchen, she was feeling quite hesitant because of she wanted to ask something. She wanted to ask for the extra money tomorrow. Then mother asked, what do you need it for? That why you need it? for ice cream, answered her brother from the door with an impish grin. You know, in a mischievous manner, like in a joking manner, her brother said, for ice cream, mom. Thumping the door with the palm of his hand, he chanted, we want ice cream, we want ice cream. Ignoring him, her mother repeated, why do you need the money, Manjula? So her little brother, he started making noises, but her mother, she ignored him and asked, why do you need the money, Manjula? For colors and paints, I want to learn painting. Then mother was feeling unbelievable. Painting? But you? She added quickly, of course, it's a nice hobby. It will be more than a hobby, replied Manjula quietly. So Manju told her mother that, no mother, it's not just a hobby. It will be more than a hobby. I love painting. Mrs. Parelkar looked at her daughter searchingly. She gazed long into those serious, melancholic eyes. Closing the tap, she walked over to the kitchen cupboard and pulled out an ornate metal tea box from the topmost shelf. So she was ready to give her money. She put that money from where she had put it. My piggy bank, she smiled. So mother told, it's my kind of piggy bank. Don't let out the hiding place. No need to tell out others about this hiding place. Then she pressed a few notes into Manjula's hands. She gave some money to her. Go ahead and buy whatever you need, dear. Have fun and show me the painting. Then Manju's mother gave her money and she was quite happy for her daughter. Manjula Parelkar showed her first painting to her mother to the very next day. Manjula, cried her mother, dropping her needlework in surprise. Why, that is beautiful. I didn't know you were this good. So when Manju showed her paintings to her mother next day, her mother amazingly replied. She was so amazed. She replied, it's so beautiful. I was not aware that you were so good. Do you really think so? Manju asked her mother. Mother, do you really think so? That I made it so beautiful? Then mother said, of course, yes. She held the watercolor painting at arm's length. It looks perfect. Oh, Ma, cried Manjula, pleased. This is just the beginning. I'll pick up fast. Then mother said, it's a perfect painting, Manju. And Manju was so happy, pleased. She was happy. She said, mother, it's just a starting. You will see what I will paint. I'm sure you will, the mother returned the painting. You must show it to Papa. He will be impressed. Then mother told her to show these paintings to her father. He will also be happy for you. Mr. Parelkar pushed his glasses up and glanced at Manju's work. Well done, very good. A nice picture. See what all you can do. Even though he didn't look at her hands, those claw-like malformed fingers, she knew what he meant. So the thing was that her father said, yes, it's very nice painting. See what all you can do. Now his father was saying, I will see that what all the things you will be able to do. You know, Manju understood what he wanted to say. She swallowed dryly. Something inside her twisting painfully. She knew the pain. She was used to it. Keep it up. Her father patted her, settling in his favorite chair with the newspaper. He inquired, is the tea ready? You know, the thing was that her father was not much, very much encouraging her. And she knew that. It always happened to her. Why don't you frame it? Cried her brother Amol, snatching the sheet from Manjula's hand. Or why don't you sell it? Raising it over his head, he imitated an auctioneer. 2,000 rupees, who bids more? 2,001, 2,002. Now her little brother Amol, he was also impressed by her painting. He asked her, why don't you frame it? You should frame it. It's so nice. Or you should sell it. And he was he was imitating the auctioneer when, like in auctions, people used to say, Amol, his mother warned him, put that painting down at once, tell me, have you finished your homework? Then his mother asked him to put that painting down. The word homework was enough to sober Amol. He crept to his room. You know, the word homework was enough for him to be quiet. He went to his room quietly. So students, tomorrow we will do the rest of the chapter, or in the next video we will do that. Till then, revise the chapter, and thank you. Have a nice day.